Do you follow up with patients or looking to set up a schedule to reach out to certain patients for maybe an only specific reason? Hi, Rachel. This is a reminder from Moon Podiatry letting you know it takes 3,685 minutes to catch up on Game of Thrones before 2019. Get to work. Well, you can set up the schedule using Cliniko's recall feature. I'll show you how in this week's Tip of the Week. Create recalls, you first need to create recall types. These are the type of calls or reminders you'd like to establish. For example, 3-week appointment follow-up, 1-year anniversary, you've been playing Pokemon Go for the last 6 months and we haven't seen you, so we miss you, etc. To add these recall types, you'll need to be an administrator or power receptionist. Head to Settings, then under Appointments, head to Recall Types. As you can see, I've already added a few, but let's go ahead and add another by clicking Recall Types. We'll title this one, Please Come Back. For the duration or recall in, this is the date the recall will take place. So if you want to follow up or call someone after 1 day or 1 week or even 1 month, you can set that up here. Want to set up the recall for 1 year? Select 12 months. The options are endless. For now, I'll set my recall for 3 months. Once you create your recall types, you can now apply these to your patients. All users have this ability, unless you're a bookkeeper. First, head to the patient's file. Then, click on Recalls. From here, click Add Recall. You can then select the recall type. I'll select the new one that was recently created. You'll notice that recall date has already been set based on your duration settings. So for Please Come Back, the date has been set to 3 months from now. You can, of course, manually change this if needed. If you want to add any notes to the recall, you can do those here. Then repeat this for any patients as needed. In terms of a recommended workflow, I've seen clinics add recalls after the appointment has ended so they can follow up on how their appointment went, or after generating reports. For example, generating a patients without upcoming appointments report, if you want to contact them after a week to schedule the next visit, generate this report, and you can even use the hide to patients with scheduled recalls filter. Extra freebie tip. If you're on a desktop, right click on the patient's name, then select open in a new tab. For mobile or tablets, long press or hold the patient name, and you'll see the option to open in a new tab as well. This way, you can apply the recall without losing the report/list you've just generated. Now, when it comes time to call a patient, you can complete a recall by heading to the patient's file directly or by heading to the reports page and generating the recalls report. Here, you'll want to set the date range you're after. So if you call patients once a week, set it for the week. You also have the option of filtering by recall type, last practitioner seen, and by last business visited. Once you have your list, you can begin your call. The phone number listed will be the patient's mobile number. If you prefer to send a letter, just click on the patient's name and send the letter from here. Clicking on the date of a recall will allow you to edit the recall in case you need to follow up on a different date. Once you've completed your follow-up, check off your call and we'll record the date of the recall and we'll display the initials of the user who completed it. That's it for creating recalls. This tip was suggested by one of our Cliniko family members, so special shout out for the suggestion. If you'd like to see any other tips come to life, let me know. And of course, I will see you next tip.